I just installed a sweet home theater system in the family room. The trouble is Claire struggles with technology of any kind. I mean, remotes, cell phones, computers. Where were you pointing at?
At the TV.
Honey, no, I'm sorry. It's a home theater.
What, so I can't point it at the TV when I want to watch the TV?
You point at the receiver.
It's a receiver.
Okay, imagine our home theater system is a human body, so then the receiver is the brain, the TV is the face,
and that's what you are.
So Betsy?
Hey, it's me.
Hey!
Listen, I've got a bunch of moms over here who want to watch the talent show. See, and I can't get the sound to work.
Is there a fixer?
Yes?
To be honest, did you do that thing where you get frustrated and you press all the buttons?
No. I have a theory that Phil installs overly complicated things in the house just so he has an excuse to talk to me like a child. Last month, he fixed that.
The snowflake button makes it cold, cold, cold. Set temperature makes it cold, cold, cold. The little flame makes it...
Hey, Daddy in the house!
Broncos defense, and he said, man, they can just smother any offense, but then there's Patrick Mahomes, and he can flat out take over against. Yes, he can, and he has shown. I mean, he has the ability to throw the football from anywhere on the field. The last two playoff games, he has become a receiving, or excuse me, a running threat as well. So it will be important to hold him within the pocket. Here's a little pitch to Williams running to his right. A nice pickup on first down is Drake Greenlaw. The rookie linebacker brings him down after a gain of 7. Well, you always come into a game as a quarterback and kind of wonder how the game's going to be called. Andy Reid, they started off with an easy little pitch by Patrick Mahomes. This is an offense that does not run the ball a lot on first and second down, but try to settle Patrick Mahomes in early. I would expect some high completion passes here in the early part of this drive. On second down, this one was knocked away. Getting a hand on it was Nick Bosa, the rookie, the Pro Bowler, and a guy who is everywhere for the 49ers. Yes, and this will be a matchup worth keeping an eye on throughout the ball game. Nick Bosa, I've got to believe, he lines up on both sides, but he's going to line up to the offensive right and work against Derek Fisher. He has shown that he struggles at times against that bull rush. He's able to get his hand there and then force a third down.
Two. They're in a 2-deep shell to start with, so they're going to be a little bit
place. Debo Samuel led all NFL wide receivers during the regular season in rush yards. He gets 32 there. He's a rookie. Here is a handoff to Coleman. And this offensive line is going to work for San Francisco as Tevin Coleman, coming off that dislocated right shoulder he suffered in the champ game, gets 7. I'll tell you what, Joe, right now Kansas City, they are playing more of a two-deep look on first down. Every first down on this possession, they have gone two-deep look, and Garoppolo has the ability to check things. Kyle Shanahan checking that out, seeing what they're doing, and they've gashed them. You know, with those runs, they're going to get them out of that in a hurry if they continue to run the football the way they have here. The first-year defensive coordinator, Steve Spagnuolo, trying to come up with an answer fast. Here is a handoff to Coleman, and he gets his yard. And so third down, and a couple coming up for the 49ers. Number 4 total offense during the regular season, and this offensive line was so good, and we probably didn't give them enough credit for what they did against the Packers defense. No, they have really come on. The last two games of the regular season, of course, what they've done in the postseason. Right now, depending on what happens here, Joe, I've got to believe Kyle Shanahan is regarding this right now as four-down territory. Mostert in the ball game. Here's another toss to Samuel. Looks like he wants to throw, and Samuel just pick it up with his leg. First down, San Francisco, and a game of 7 as Anthony Hitchens made the stop, and the impressive drive continues for Kyle Shanahan. Well, they were definitely going to throw it, but watch Derek Nottie. They were going to come back to Jimmy Garoppolo on the throwback, and Nottie, he recognizes it. He gets out there. Is he going to be able to make a play? I don't know, but good enough for Debo Samuel to tuck it and then go and pick up the first down. Good decision on his part. He's a big-bodied wide receiver, 215 pounds. Any way they can, they want to put it in his hands. They've done it twice. A couple trick plays already by Jackson on this opening drive. Heavy pressure. Pass is caught by Mostert. He is swallowed up immediately by Mike Sinnel. That's number 2. So this defense got better and better as the season went on. They are missing a couple of big pieces, including their rookie free safety, Juan Thornhill, who went down week 17 to a torn ACL. Yeah, and that was fairly significant, although Daniel Sorensen, he has stepped in, a guy who was a starter a couple of years ago, and here he is back here, and he's done a good job in the two postseason games, but you're right, they have shown improvement coming off one of their best performances, if not their best performance in the AFC Championship. Here's a throw to Samuel. Nothing there. Kittle blocked. Taken care of by the Kansas City defense as Rashad Breeland got through and made the stop. A loss of 2. Really great job by Rashad Breeland in being physical and playing through the block. The throw a little bit high, so he's not able to catch that on the move. Protection for Garoppolo, and the pass is incomplete. Looked like it was tipped. Damian Wilson may have gotten a hand on it to bring up fourth down. Well, Steve Spagnuolo, you're going to double up George Kittle. You're going to get underneath him and take him away. And that situation, third and five, and Garoppolo has to go elsewhere. That's immediately where he was looking to go. And so Kansas City, although 49ers able to put together a pretty good drive, they're at least able to make a stop, and that's going to be the key. Both these offenses come into this game in the postseason, having played well in the red zone. Bobby Gould from 38. First point to the game belong to the 49ers. Kansas City went 3-and-out. San Francisco got into field goal range, and the bet, Robbie Gould, knocks it through. Just underway, Super Bowl 54. Hank Stram, the Hall of Famer, the late great Hank Stram.
That never gets old, does it?
It just doesn't. And I got to know Hank early on in my life. He was my dad's radio broadcast partner on Monday Night Football on CBS Radio, and that was Hank.
You got good Hank stories,
though. I got good Hank stories. Those are the post-game. Look how things have changed since Super Bowl IV. It was the 69th season, January of 1970. The average ticket price is a little more steep. Cost of a 30-second commercial, a lot more steep. Halftime act, and then the play-by-play guy.
How about that? So the more things change, the more they stay the same.
Congratulations, Kyle. I know that's meaningful to you, as it should be. It's awesome to be working alongside you tonight.
Thank you, buddy.
It is to my mom. I know that. From the 25, Mahomes out to his right, finds Tyreek Hill, and he gets 9. Take a look at the defense for San Francisco. The Chiefs now have opened every game this postseason with 3-and-out. That was against Houston, then against Tennessee. And look at his defense that held Kansas City to a 3-and-out. First time they had the football. Flag on the play on the far side. down to Damian Williams. The 49ers declined the penalty, and on third and short, a gain of five. Kansas City went 12-4. They won the AFC West. Patrick Mahomes, the third player in NFL history to win an MVP award, which he did last year, and made the Super Bowl over his first three seasons, joining Marino and Warner, and they overcame 10-plus point deficits in both postseason games so far. Quick draw pass caught, that's Kelsey. He gets nine. Jaquaski's cart downfield to make the stop. Oh, the play action in the backfield. Oh, Fred Warner is keeps him from being able to get over there to make the play on this throw. Watch what the action in the backfield does, and that creates the little lane there to get in there to Travis Kelce. And so for an offense that doesn't run the ball really all that well, they're awfully good in their play action passing. It proves the theory that you don't have to be a great running team to have great play action game. It's Williams, another first down and more. Down inside the 30, where Sherman makes the stop at a gain of 15. Well, you get movement like this on Sheldon Day, the defensive tackle, the push that the Chiefs are able to get on him. He just completely gets wiped out. They're in the middle of the field, and it opens up a heck of a lane for Damian Williams. He started this game with LeSean McCoy not active, so Darwin Thompson is the backup to Williams. He's in there now. The rookie from Utah State. Little toss to Hill. Makes the move, and Warner doesn't fight. Forced out of bounds after a gain of four. The Pepsi Super Bowl 54 halftime show is coming up right here on Fox. Sherman on Kelce right here.
Why would you do that to a brand new, very expensive remote?
Because I lost my temper and it didn't work. And so it's useless.
Well, honey, when it comes to anything electronic, you're not exactly the best student.
I am really smart. I had a 4.0 in college. How about you?
I was almost that, despite my substantial time commitment to cheerleading.
Help me if you did not bring up the cheerleading.
Seriously, Claire, you owe me an apology for breaking that.
Okay. So I apologize for breaking the workforce remote. You bought. Stupid.
Excuse me, but the experts at CNET.com rated it the best remote. They gave it 3.5 mice.
Wow, well, I have an idea. Let's invite the gang from CNET over and your old buddies from cheerleading and we can have a nerd party.
Lane's not a nerd. He built his own helicopter. And if he was alive today... You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to buy a new remote. The same remote. And just to prove how wrong you are, I'm going to teach our dumbest kid how to use it in 20 minutes or less.
Who's our dumbest kid?
Luke.
Luke? No, Luke understands electronics. Haley.
No.
Yeah, Haley. Teach Haley to use the remote, and then I'll apologize.
Haley?
Mm-hmm.
Come on! Now press the button labeled activities.
Where is that?
Is it to the right? To the right. And now choose watch DVD. Honey, gotta focus. We've only got 20 minutes. Pretend the mall's closing.
Dad, this is stupid. I watch TV on my computer. Why do I have to learn this?
Because your mom doesn't think you can.
Nobody can.
Haley, listen to me. I know this seems impossible, but this is for all those times that mom told you she was right, and you knew she was wrong.
I'll do it.
That's my girl. Haley? You ready?
Let's do this. Turn on the TV.
Nice.
Mute it. Unmute it. On DVD. Step forward. Okay. Back to TV. Don't get all cocky, Phil. Let's see what happens to little Haley when I do this. Oh. Dad, what do I do?
No panic. We went through this. Just think.
Give up and make defeat. Okay. Okay, let's see. You put the remote onto TV mode, and then press input till you get HDMI 1. And... You proved your point. Everybody in this house is smarter than me.
No, honey, you're missing the point. I taught Haley how to use the remote in 20 minutes, so think how fast you can learn it.
What's that supposed to mean?
You see what I'm saying?
Downfield, Emmanuel Sanders. Well, we've seen Kansas City. They've run the two deep on early downs on the first couple possessions. Now they go single high and start creeping up. Trying to play that run game. Now off the play out. See that nice window there. They change the run below high, I think. That is a good feeling for a quarterback when you come off with that look and you've got that kind of room to fit it in there. 7-3 ball game in Super Bowl 54 after one. On Super Bowl Sunday return. After this, from the local Buccaneers. Came in with the injury to Quan Alexander, and as far as McCole Hardman goes, awfully dynamic. He made the Pro Bowl as a return guy. We know what kind of speed he has, and he's got a really bright future. Second down and 9. Handoff here to Damian Williams. And with Bosa making the tackle, a gain of 5. You know, it has been interesting. What we've seen from Kansas City is them being willing to run the football. And the 49ers, they've had issues at times this season being able to play the run. They have felt when they've had to stop the run, they've been able to do that. But they're okay with that, I can promise you. The focus for them is not giving up the big plays and also coming up with deep stops down at this end of the field.
Where he and the Chiefs won it all. It became
13 on the return. Guys got that at the 20. Tonight's Super Bowl features several 5G firsts from Verizon, including the first time a 5G-enabled wireless camo will be used to deliver live shots of the game. There's 5G, then there's Verizon 5G. Joe, you look at this first half, hard to believe. The 49ers have only had two possessions. They've run just 12 plays in this first half. A very important drive right now for them. Handoff here is to Mostert. He doesn't get much. The hero of the camp game had 220 rush yards and four touchdowns as Pitchens and Noddy combine on the stop, and that's his first carry with 9 minutes left in the half. Yeah, the 49ers, they've just not been able to get the running game going. The reason it looks even halfway decent is because of Deebo Samuel with a 32-yard run. Otherwise, they've been bottled up pretty good. So this Kansas City defense picking right up where they left off in that AFC Championship game against Derrick Henry and the Titans. Held Henry to 69 rush yards. After he dominated the Patriots and the Ravens, here's a toss. Mostert running left, looking for a lane. And a nice gain on second and nine. We'll see where they mark him out. Looks like enough for a first down. And it is. Well, that's some good blocking. All these wide receivers. This time, Kendrick Bourne, he's able to help get the edge and get him on the outside. Kendrick Bourne, 84, he goes in motion. And then he comes up, of course, Kittle. You see the job that they do. There's a lot of bodies over there. And these receivers, Kyle Shanahan has made it clear, if you're not willing to block, you're not going to play. Here's a little push pass to Samuel. Another big run by the rookie. Tyrann Mathieu on the stop after a carry of 16 yards. And it will go down as a pass, but a strong run after the catch by Deebo Samuel nonetheless. Yeah, and then Samuel, Raheem Mostert, he's the lead blocker on that. So he's serving in the Kyle Juszczyk role. And then, of course, Kittle, look at the job he does on Thornton. He just knocked him right out of the frame. That's, you know, when you try to settle down a quarterback after throwing an interception, come back with the running game, and even with overloaded front, again, on this look right now, the 49ers have been able to come up with some pretty good runs. Here's a handoff to Mostert. Nice cut upfield, and he's got 10-plus. Grayland on the tackle. But Raheem Mostert, undrafted out of Purdue on his 7th team in the NFL, and he has finally found traction with the 49ers, and the Packers had no answer for him two Sundays ago. And no, you're right. I mean, he was kind of everywhere and doing so much, and it's been a nice story, of course. And then Tevin Coleman, he's the guy, a little bit more of the thumper. And they got the thumper in the lineup now with Kittle at fullback. Quick snap, hand off to Coleman. Nice run, Tevin Coleman, down near the 25. A carry of 17 yards, and the ground game is starting to work for the 49ers. That's that power game inside by San Francisco, and right now this offensive line, these backs are rolling, and we've seen it so many times. Kyle Shanahan, when he feels like he's got a hot hand, and they're moving people like they are right now, he doesn't get away from it very often. This drive, four runs in that one pass. It was basically a run on that push pass to Deebo Samuel. Garoppolo keeps throws. Good catch. Samuel, first down. Boy, that kid is tough. Gonna come back with the read option. And once the linebacker flows, then Samuel, you know, he's got to beat Freeland. You're counting on that part of it, but then there's no underneath coverage. And Deebo Samuel, he's developed into a nice receiver also. Talking about McCole Hardman for the Kansas City Chiefs. Deebo Samuel potentially become their number one guy. Heck, he was the lead receiver with just five catches in the postseason after the two games coming into this one. Garoppolo keeps play action, passes, caught. Juszczyk, touchdown. flag in his hip pocket. He's got to put the ball in the perfect position. He makes the play, hit the keeper, and then go get in the end zone. This guy's a heck of a football player. Gold. 10-10. Garoppolo coming off the interception, just found his fifth different receiver of the ball game. He's got his young head coach pumped up. We've got a touchdown to the fullback Juszczyk. We've got a tie in Miami. Michelob Ultra, pure gold. Fun shot to this one, 10-10 with 5:05 left in the first half. Seven play touchdown drive. Last five plays of that seven play drive all covered 10 or more yards. Hartman, dangerous returner for Kansas City. Gets a chance, gets to the 20, and that is it. Elijah Lee on the stop. Now Juszczyk has the first 49er touchdown of this Super Bowl. Aaron Andrews, he's been fun to watch.
Yeah, absolutely. And this 49er sideline just absolutely erupted after he scored that touchdown. Juice, as they call him. He lined up a tight end, halfback wide receiver, and is one of the best blockers in the game. Kyle Shanahan says he's been able to handle it. He thinks because of the Harvard education, but he's also a heck of a football player, guys.
Yeah, Aaron, and I guess not fitting. I mean, he's one of these unselfish players that the 49ers have on offense, and he gets the first touchdown.
Hey, after that return, Nicole Hartman, he should look to. He came off pretty sore.
Mahomes. Damian Williams makes the move, and then out of bounds with a catch and run of about 10. Ron Alexander, the one who whipped on that tackle, is where they are checking Nicole Hartman after that big hit by Elijah Lee on the left arm. Yeah, and that's what it appears that they were checking, Joe, but as soon as he got to the sideline walking off, he was bent over a couple times. Trainer immediately reached to him, and he's been over there with him on the sideline every game. That's the pick the Chiefs got when they traded D-Ford to San Francisco. He's up at the top of the defensive formation. Here's a pass complete. That's tight end Blake Bell. He gets 9, 9.5, mostly on the stop. That's the Super Bowl 54 halftime show.
problem?
Honey, you look nice. Why?
Did I hear Mom? Wait, you're dressed like a girl. No, you are not using the window. You got the last one.
Did everyone know about this window?
You guys need it too? For what?
Oh, wow, it is not easy doing something that dumb.
Yeah, this is why men are over. I hope you enjoyed the last 10,000 years.
Listen, I have to bail on our trip with Mom for Mother's Day.
No, I have to bail. You have to go. She cried when we asked her.
But my boss invited me to the med ball. Her therapy dog got the flu, so I get to fly first class. Well, on her lap.
But Bill wants to take me away. This is the first time I've had a boyfriend who's not spending Mother's Day watching Driving Miss Daisy and pulling gray hairs out of a hairbrush.
3 houses in one window is unprecedented. If we're going to pull this off, we're going to have to make this the most relaxing environment she's ever walked into.
Surprise!
Nana?
Dee
Dee! I'm sorry to barge in. I was visiting Mitch and Cam. There's some tension over there. Well, where's my daughter? I don't hear any cooking or cleaning sounds, so I assume she's home.
Dad, what do we do?
Mitchell must have brought her. Maybe he's still out. Coward!
Garoppolo deep throw, pass caught, he's checked, who has a touchdown. Has a first down and a gain of 14 yards. Checked out of the backfield. It looks like Reggie Ragland. Sure enough, he's the one who, you know, with his play action, he's going to come up and try to take on that lead blocker. Instead, Juszczyk runs right past him. They got a double on the outside, and it was a pretty easy catch for the Harvard fullback. Garoppolo throws. Kittle gets blocked. And then lowers his shoulder into Sorensen, picks up five. Good job by Jimmy Garoppolo just getting the ball out. They have numbers in their favor. They got the two blockers in front. Get the ball into the hands quickly and let him pick up positive yards. Essentially a wide running play on that type of high percentage pass. Oh, the fun just begins when Kittle catches. He goes looking for contact. Samuel at the bottom. Hand off to Mostert running left. Back to the line of scrimmage, and that's all. Play made by Damian Wilson. Former fourth round pick by the Dallas Cowboys in 2015, his first year with Kansas City, made that stop. Yeah, it's an excellent play on his part, too. He's been a good addition to this defense, and the job that he does right here, 54 in the middle. Watch it, he gets knocked to the ground. It's his second effort, and he's able to get back up. Of course, you got Kyle Passanio, who misses him, but it slows him up to where Wilson is able to come up and make the play. 49ers 2-for-3 on third down. Third down and 5. Pass is caught by Coleman short of the first down. George Kittle, I think Garoppolo just didn't hang with him, or Kittle's walking off wondering why he didn't get the ball thrown to him. He clears that first level zone player, the linebacker, and right there's a big hole right in the middle, and he knows that was one that... That would have kept the drive alive. That would have been a first down. Robbie Gould is in his 15th year in the NFL, 37 years old. He's been around long enough, and he's kicking for the second time in a Super Bowl in this stadium. A member of the Bears, and they lost to Indy in Super Bowl 41. 1-for-1 in this game, 2-for-2 in Super Bowl effort. This from 42.
Finds his man Watkins. Sammy Watkins takes it up to the 29.
A gain of 19 yards where Sherman brought him down. Well, the inside pass rush, it affords Mahomes then to get outside on the edge. And these receivers, they are really good, probably the best in the league, in going and finding a spot. You see Sammy Watkins, how he continues to work. A lot of these guys, you watch them, they stay plastered to defenders. And you watch the Chiefs, regardless of who it is, they do an excellent job of separating and giving Mahomes the place to run the football. Mahomes over the middle for Kelce. Travis Kelce to the 32, a gain of 4 where Sherman brought him down. You know, this is a Kansas City offense. When you talk about all the big plays, and I said coming in, they led the league in pass completions of over 40 yards, and they're one of the best at pass completions of 20 yards. It's a big play offense, it's a fast break offense. But they also have the ability to drive the ball down the field in 10-play drives. They're one of the best in 10-play drives, and they can play that game as well. Here is Damian Williams. Sheldon Day is there for San Francisco in no game. The problem with it, however, Joe, is when you're accustomed to the big play, you tend to get frustrated as an offense. And what even frustrates you more is when you come into this game and you are the number one third down offense, converting 47%, and here they are tonight, just 1%. Now, they converted a couple four downs, but the 49ers, they have won this down. Usually you win this down, you win the game. Third and 6, Mahomes floats, Watkins first down. A 9-yard completion to Sammy Watkins coming off a big game in the AFC Championship against Tennessee. You see the block by Damian Williams. He takes out deep four. And so it just kind of buys a little more time. Get Mahomes out on the corner, threatening the defense. You know, Mahomes didn't have a lot of runs this year. He didn't have a lot of yards running, especially coming off that injury. But he is a threat after over 50 yards in those two playoff games of keeping it and running it. Delayed handoff here to Damian Williams. Bosa there for the stop, a gain of 5. Warner joined in on the punt as well, and Damian Williams lost his 2. Bosa Jordan. Squad. And then you've got Fred Warner right here in the middle. When the route is run at the top of this route. Tyreek Hill is going to see that the lane is right here. That's where the ball needs to be thrown. That's where he's expecting it. Instead, Mahomes, the ball just kind of gets away from him, or whatever it is, but Tyreek Hill has every intention to drive to that open spot, and typically, you watch Mahomes play, he's leading the receiver right into that hole. Hand off here to Mostert.
Tennessee Titans. They're 24-0 in the first half against Houston and led 28-22.
just not going to give up anything deep. Only one pass attempt by Mahomes over 20 yards in this ball game, and that was the 28-yarder they completed to Sammy Watkins. Second down and 10. Hand off to Williams. Nice run on second and 10 and 5. Kwan Williams on the stop. It fires. He's sensing some frustration sitting in down there. Tyrann Mathieu, after that 49er touchdown drive, came over to the Chiefs sideline. He was really upset. Sat down, got up, steaming hot, yelling. Defensive coordinator Steven Spagnuolo had to calm him down. Chris Jones eventually came over. Looks like tightening things up. Mathieu was the guy chosen last night to address the team as they got ready for today's game. One of their emotional leaders. He's upset right now. Third down and 5. Gets away and dives for what is close to first down yardage, and they've given it to him. First down, Kansas City, on the run by Patrick Mahomes.
Well, that's Eric Armstead for San Francisco. He collapses the pocket, but he doesn't maintain outside. Watch right here. He gets up the field, but he pushes in and he allows Mahomes then the corner. And Mahomes has shown time after time here in recent weeks his ability to do this, and that was a huge third down conversion for Kansas City. All the momentum with the 49ers, they're moving the ball offensively. They could ill afford to punt the ball right back to San Francisco if they failed to make that. On first down, Mahomes throws low and behind Watkins. Well, that was Mahomes' worst throw of the day. He had Sammy Watkins. A lot of attention paid to Kelce. Tyreek Hill is going to get a lot of attention, and any number of guys after that can step up on any given play, but Sammy Watkins has kind of been the guy that's been targeted for some of these bigger plays. Five catches, 44 yards.
longest catch of the game. Mahomes keeps. Steps up, throws to Williams out of the backfield. Tackle missed. What a catch and run. Quan Alexander couldn't bring him down, and a 13-yard play is the result. Damian Williams. They tried to get the ball to Tyreek Hill. Pretty good route by him, and Mahomes gets flushed a little bit, and then he gets the ball out here to Williams, and those are the plays you just have to be able to make. Quan Alexander, he missed him. He's got the sideline to help him. And so what should have been a minimal gain ends up being a first down. Alexander missed 8 games with a torn back. They thought he was dead when he went down on Halloween against Arizona. Came back to the playoffs. They got something down here with Cole Hardman on his previous run. Mahomes is swallowed up for the sack by Buckner. And a loss of 9. That defensive front stepped up for San Francisco. Yeah, there was nothing good about this play. I'm not sure what Mahomes was trying to do. They fake it like they're going to cross it to Kelsey, and I don't know where he's running off to. He had the edge again. There was no containment by San Francisco out to his left side. But it seems like whenever they've got something going, the 49ers have been able to come up with a negative play against this offense. Third sack of the night for San Francisco. Now Mahomes flies through. Turns it into a big game as he broke a couple of tackles. Both Dee Ford and DeForest Buckner missed tackles along the way. That's where it is so difficult when you're rushing four guys to both contain on the edges and then stay within those inside lanes and keeping Mahomes from taking it. You can see what happens. That opens up, and then he runs and is able to turn this into now a very manageable third down. Got 13 yards, 36. Mahomes pass behind and pick. Intercepted by the 49ers. Off the arm of Tyreek Hill and into the arms of Tarvarius Moore. The throw behind the receiver Hill. And the 49ers have their second takeaway of this ball game. And that stops the drive in its track. Last time the 49ers won the Super Bowl 25 years ago, and that happened here. With a 9-26 win over the Chargers. 49ers take over after the interception and hand to Mostert. And Mostert on first down gets 6. Back to the interception by Moore. That was Jaquaski's card. He's right here. He's going to come. He's looking up anything that's coming inside. But he's going to get a hit. Tyreek Hill as if he catches it. But a ball, if it's on the money. Robert Sala, he's liking what he's seeing. But if that ball's on the money from Mahomes, that's a first down. It was just a throw that was behind him, and then Tarvarius Moore comes up with the play. And we all know what's happening right now. Kyle Shanahan is going to run this ball right down their throat if they let him. Garoppolo keeps. Pass is caught on a sliding grab by Kittle. After the first career interception by Tarvarius Moore, all of a sudden, in a blink, the 49ers are out near their own 38. Yeah, we came into this second half, Joe, talking about the decision by Kyle Shanahan to not take the timeout. And maybe he was a little conservative with how he handled that. But this second half, Jimmy Garoppolo, he has been on fire. He has made throws, most of them, off of the play action. And he's gotten the ball to the playmakers. And he's been really good. Run only 3 incompletions, 1 touchdown, 1 interception, and a handoff to Mostert gets 1. I'm starting to get a little bit chippy out there, as you would expect right now. The Chiefs, with 10 minutes and 20 seconds in counting, it's a critical drive for them right now. They obviously, they got to make a stop, but they got to make a stop now. 18 completions more in this game for Garoppolo than he had over the two previous playoff games combined. The win over the Vikings and the win over the Packers, second and nine. Garoppolo throws, pass too high, incomplete for Deebo Samuel. Chiefs brought a blitz, and that's what threw off the timing and the accuracy by Garoppolo. That's Anthony Hitchens, and he comes in on the blitz and forces. Garoppolo's trying to get it out, and the ball sailed on. So it's a good here for Kansas City. They need to come up with a big play here on third down and get the ball back to Mahomes and company. We'll see if Steve Spagnuolo decides to bring some pressure and force the ball out of Garoppolo's hands quickly. Penalty flag on the play. Looked like it might have been a false start, and it is.
Down carry.
interceptions, three sacks. Bosa with one of them, and he checks out in some pain. So here's one-on-one at the top, and Bosa, offense number 76. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
You know, these looks, and I know Andy Reid is talking with Chris Myers. There's the false start. Says that you know, they're just not there. Sometimes when you've got one-on-one, especially with Tyreek Hill, it's one-on-one with Emmanuel Mosley. Now, Mosley's off, but there's a lot of things to be thrown when you've got a guy playing that type of position. Mahomes throws, pass is incomplete. Hill the target, Mosley there. That's where Mahomes went with it, but not down the field. Yeah, now that time they did move the safety. They gave him a little bit of help. So they helped out with Mosley, but there is someone single covered down the field with an opportunity to make a play. There's been times when Richard Sherman has been out there one-on-one. They just have not been able to get the route along with the coverage to where it's been a favorable look for Mahomes.
What was in the tea?
Mom just pulled up. Quick, longest sawdust press with this, then medium, then shortest.
Yeah. That's the first straw, you're last.
I've never done it to a world with a smaller size thing. Sucks, you guys are going to use a bottle on poppy pies.
Oh,
sorry, we didn't finish the laundry.
Oh, well, don't sweat it, handsome. Read the paper. We ain't got a problem.
Oh. Mom, we made you lunch, and it's still pretty outside.
Yeah, I love that idea.
I have a family.
It is a picnic. I'm happy right here.
Oh, we're just so nervous that we overdressed the salad. I can't even watch you taste this.
Mom, I hate to have to ask you this, but would you mind if I missed out on another weekend?
Oh, no, why?
Well, Bill only gets one weekend off a month,
and she wants to take me to go.
What?
Bill? Thank you, Mom. No, I should say no. Let's face it, those books aren't keeping me warm at night. Put some bugs in those teeth, huh?
Mom, you are the best. Thank you so much. That is so sweet. What did you just
sing, James? No, I was not. And Miss Dunphy, my eyes are up here.
Oh. Where's the sound?
The house is settled.
Anyway, these are really good at work, Mom. I finally realized how much sacrifice it took to have a career. You know, my boss, like, he wants me to go with him on this business trip, but it couldn't come at a worse weekend.
Welcome to the struggle, sister.
Just close.
Window? What window?
Great news. We moved the box in the garage. Mm-hmm. The craziest thing happened.
Talk about crazy things. You know how the Met Ball is in New York and how I did a famous comedian-sized dog.
Bailey's grown-ups are talking.
Obsessed. The knots are coming back. Mama's bailing on our trip.
I made Dad play and we flew our turn into your face.
A man named Nigel Pickles may have our bank account numbers.
I'm gonna go. Stop. Sit down.
Clearly, you all have bad news to tell me, but you have to dump it on me, Randy. You? You did. That's what the window is for 1 hour a month when I am inhuman to you people.
Can't I just wander?
Let me tell you something. You debutantes have it easy. You wouldn't have survived one day. And now, where I grew up, where an actual crazy person is running the show.
Oh, Claire.
The guilting, the shaming, the number of times I heard that. Where did I go wrong with you, Mom?
Mom, Nana's here.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Say that. I know where I'm not wanted. And no, I'm not trying to guilt you. I can't waste the energy on that, because I am basically homeless now that my marriage has unraveled. No. You're going to sit here in silence until it is my turn. Your mouth.
First three and out with 5:18 to go.
And if they're able to get any kind of return off of this, they're going to have excellent field position. Cole Hartman, the rookie, averaged over 9 yards per punt return during the regular season.
Out of that.
look at it every possible way. Right now, this is the go-ahead touchdown in the fourth quarter of a Super Bowl. He reached, got it across the goal line, but it looked like that right foot might have been out. Here's another look. Haven't seen anything definitive, however, to overturn the call on the field.
Yeah, I agree. There's just nothing really just straight down the line to know, you know, if the tip of that ball is if it's part of that white line. I don't know if there's going to be anything there that they're going to be able to overturn it. And this play officially under review. Pretty good design play, though, there. With, you know, I circled Travis Kelce. And he pushes up, and it allows Williams then to be able to get the ball with some room to run. You see the right foot already on the boundary. As they try to piece this together. Remember, that was a third down play, Mike.
Well, Joe, I look at this one and say, man, it is so close to call. With so many of them there are involving the pine line. Is the ball breaking the plane? You need that shot down the line. The closest one down the line here, you can see the tip of the ball just has to break the plane. And the foot is down out of bounds, but it's that point. I just don't think, again, this doesn't look to me to be clear enough to overturn.
It was third down and goal, so if this call's overturned and they move it outside the goal line, it would be fourth down.
After reviewing the play, the ruling on the field stands. Kansas City officially on top. And Patrick Mahomes on that drive went 5 for 5, 60 yards and a touchdown. Damian Williams, his 10th career postseason touchdown, tied for second among active players now. They call him Playoff Damian. And he took the throw and was just able to get it in. This is a 4-point game with 2:44 left. Down 10 points, and really a weak chance. You see the celebration there in the sweep, and you can't let up. You just cannot let up against this group. I mean, think about it. Kyle Shanahan challenges the call, the Tyreek Hill catch that's incomplete, brings up third and long, and it looked like you're thinking, okay, well, are they going to go for it if they don't make it on fourth down? Instead, they get the huge play then down the field to Tyreek Hill, and it was game on at that point. The Chiefs now put up 14 straight after the 49ers scored 17 straight, and the focus spotlight falls back on the other side, and Jimmy Garoppolo. Tell you what, though, don't go to sleep on Jimmy Garoppolo. Think back to that Saints team. Now, he only had to get him down the field for a field goal. He didn't have a whole lot of time to work with. He's got plenty of time, only now he's got to come away with a touchdown. And, you know, for that narrative all week, for the last 2 weeks, actually, about not wanting to expose him, the running game, he gets a chance to put all that to bed. James brings it from the goal line. And he takes it to the 20. Down just across the 15-yard line by Byron Pringle. He's been all over the place on special teams for the Chiefs.
Now, I don't think you can say enough for the special teams unit for the Kansas City Chiefs in their kick coverage teams. I mean, they've been really good.
The drive will start at the 15-yard line. Cuts upfield. Good start to this possession. Already out to the 32.
made the tackle, but not before 17 yards. He's pretty soft in coverage, soft with the linebackers, and we've seen it so many times when, of course, they got three timeouts. You know they don't have to abandon the run, but Al Shanahan knows how good they are in that department, and they pick up just as many yards on the ground, we've seen it, than they do in the air. And the play being shut down. Just over 2 minutes to go. Looked like there might have been movement before the snap.
Ball start. Offense number 17. 5 yard penalty. Still first down.
So they'll reset the game clock and take it back outside 2 minutes. The 2:02. They called that on Emmanuel Sanders. There it was. Picked up in October from the Broncos. Yeah, he was reacting to Frank Clark. And got called for the penalty. First down at 15, Garoppolo, Kittle. And he's able to lower his shoulder, get a couple of extra yards. Didn't need to go out of bounds with a 2 minute warning coming up, and he gets 8. With a minute 56 remaining in the ballgame. 24-20. Chiefs on top. Super Bowl 54. Finally the night for 61-year-old Andy Reid, who spent 14 years as the head coach of the Eagles, got his team to the Super Bowl. Super Bowl 39 lost to Tom Brady and the New England Patriots, or will it be Kyle Shanahan in his third year with the 49ers? Super Bowl win for San Francisco. Pass is caught by Bourne. And he is out of bounds near midfield. And they're going to mark him at the Kansas City 49. Shoved out by Ward after a gain of 16. It looked to me like Bourne just kind of ad-libbed a little bit right there. He's running a pivot route, China route on the outside. And he realizes the coverage in front. Throws Garoppolo off a little bit. But because he had time in the pocket, Bourne is able to uncover himself, and Garoppolo finds him. That's a pretty good ad-lib job by those two players. Garoppolo has it batted into the air, and it falls to the ground. Chris Jones gets another. This is the stadium where Joe Montana found John Taylor in Super Bowl 23 to beat the Cincinnati Bengals 20-16 with a game hanging in the balance. And now it's not Montana, it's Jimmy Garoppolo. He was traded to the 49ers from the Patriots in 2017, trying to make his mark in Super Bowl history. Pass is nearly picked by Kendall Fuller as he came flashing through. Yeah, Jimmy Garoppolo is really fortunate there. As Fuller, he leads it the entire way. He knows he's getting help on the inside, and that could have very easily been intercepted. Chris Jones got a little piece of that pass as it sailed past the line. Now third down and 10. Garoppolo now has it knocked
incomplete. Clark was there and had pressure for the Kansas City defense. That was awfully close to delay a game, and there is a flag down, but that happened during the play.
Rolling on the field as the quarterback is in the ground. Therefore, the play is dead. There's no illegal touching. First down, Kansas City.
Kansas City takes over on down to the minute 25 left. The pressure that Kansas City brings, and they get to him, and just no chance whatsoever. And Garoppolo just trying to make something happen there on fourth down. But now, with the three timeouts, there is still a chance. But it's up to this defense now. That'll go down as a sack for Frank Clark. Traded to the Chiefs from Seattle. His fifth of this postseason. Handoff here. Damian Williams plows ahead on first down. Timeout taken by the 49ers after a gain of four. Go back to that fourth and 10 play and watch the play clock in the background. Yeah, they'll normally look at that, Joe, the official. When it hits zero, then they look to see if the ball is being snapped, and that was not the case. Yeah, that was a little longer than normal. Mike?
Well, I think, we're looking at a super, super, super slow motion. We looked at here at regular speed, and you can see the back judge moving forward. He's going to get ready to call it, but by the time he sees the clock turn zero, then by the time he then looks to the ball, it's already being snapped. Those are that little acceptable time frame in real time where you don't have a foul.
That would have shut that play down, obviously. Now second and six, Williams makes the cut. Will roll to exhale.
just trying to buy some time and let those guys get down the field where he can try to make a play. But you know, you mentioned Andy Reid, Joe, and one of the most respected and most liked guys in all of football and really the history of the game. There's so many people that have been touched by him and what he has meant to them. I know his players love him. They love him in Philadelphia. They love him when he's coaching in Green Bay. They certainly love him in Kansas City. He's turned this program around in the very first year. I know there's a lot of people really happy for him to, short of some miracle happening, to come away with a Super Bowl win.
They did make the announcement that that last play was an incomplete pass, not a fumble. That Kansas City Chiefs Super Bowl IV winning team, 10 members of that team ended up in the Hall of Fame. 17 total from the Chiefs and the Vikings that met at Tulane Stadium. But how many players have come and gone? Great players, great coaches for the Chiefs that have not been able to take this moment.
This is Pitt. Kendall Fuller up to get it. And that will end this game with under a minute to go.
Seconds remain and they keep Mahomes out there.
world champions here in Miami. As they win it here in Super Bowl 54.